We've been working through the parts in this motorcycle, so we're going to continue by recreating the rear wheel. Now the rear wheel, as you can see, will be a revolved part, and it's symmetrical left to right. So we'll be able to get away with sketching just a quarter of it. So let's get started. I'm going to sketch on the front plane. And I've turned on some settings here that I want to use. I'm snapping to the grid, take advantage of all of that. I'm also using inch units, and I have some constraint settings turned on, such as auto constraining. There are some limitations to this, which I'll demonstrate right here. I've got the line turned on, and you can see that it's identifying the x-axis, and as I sketch, it identifies the origin and the z-axis, and it also gets the vertical and horizontal relationships automatically. There are a couple of relationships it didn't get that you might hope that it would get, and let's take a look at those right now. If I grab the endpoint and drag it off the origin, it moves. Okay, it didn't pick up an automatic relationship to the origin, and it didn't pick up relationships to either of the axes. So if I want it to stick to the origin, after I sketch it there, I've got to use the lock symbol to lock it in place. Now if I try to move it, it says lock point can't be moved. That's your sign that it's where it needs to be. It's a good idea when you have an involved sketch, especially sketches that have angles and arcs in them, it's a good idea to dimension them as you go. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to use the grid snap to some extent. I'll start at the 1-inch height level and go to 4 inches the way I know this should go, and draw in an angled line. Now I'm going to stop with escape twice, zoom in a little bit, and apply some dimensions. The first dimension I'm going to apply will be between the center line and the inside diameter of the hub. And this is just going to be a radial dimension in the end, because this will be revolved and it's half of the actual diameter. And next, we'll apply a 4-inch dimension. Even if this is what you need it to be, you need to go through the steps of going through the dialog or just press the lock icon. For example, if I wanted this to be 1 inch, I could just click on the lock and leave it there. However, I need to change that to 0.5 and put a dimension here between that line and this point. Make that 2. We'll just click the lock. Now, the next thing I need is and this arc has to have the center point on the center line. I want this to be a spherical surface, so I'll just press A on the keyboard to start the arc, and I'll click on a couple of points. I don't know any dimensions right now, so I'll just sketch it in and then start to move things. Now, if I didn't have these other dimensions and relationships on, moving this would be kind of dangerous. You can see that angle isn't behaving very well. So let's lock down that angle before we go any further. I'll click on this line, shift click the angled line, get the angle dimension, and we'll call this 30 degrees. Now I can put a relationship between the arc center point, just click on that, and shift click on this line to give those a coincident relationship. Now this allows me to do a lot of different things in a constrained manner. And this will always remain a spherical surface when it revolves. Let's pull it up here and then give this a dimension. Call this 9 inches, and we'll give it a dimension off of the center line or center plane as well. So we'll back out a little ways and put this dimension on. This is 4.5 inches. Now everything's locked down. Continue sketching lines. L on the keyboard. Click. Angled line. And I'm just going to leave this as a straight line right now. We'll come back later and change it to an arc. But for now, we're just going to roughly sketch in some of these items. We'll get in some more dimensions. Click between these two, make this 120. And between these two, and make that 20 degrees. Now I'll convert this end line to construction and add an arc. And I'm going to zoom in a little for this. Hit A on the keyboard to get an arc and place the two endpoints and then drag this out. This doesn't get the relationships I need, so I'll click on the line, shift click on the arc, get the tangent, click, shift click, tangent. Now I can add a dimension, and this should be a quarter inch radius. And there's another dimension I need to apply here. That's between the center point and this midplane. This should be a 6-inch dimension. Now from here, I can change a couple of these other dimensions because they don't look right to me. We haven't got a dimension for this line, so I'm just going to move it up and we'll control this dimension from this other line on the rim. Now I'm not modeling this after an actual motorcycle wheel model that I've measured, but that's not really the point here. The point is to understand a little bit about sketching, dimensioning, revolved features, and general workflow. We'll make this 0.75. And once we've got everything the way we want it, we'll just look over this one last time. I'll change this to a 3-inch dimension. Make it a little narrower in the middle. 2.5 will probably do. And now I want to revolve the part. So the first thing I'll do is hit Control 1. Control 1 changes to an isometric view, and it pops you out of the sketch, and you can see that you have an enclosed area with the sketch. You can also see that this time I didn't trim up this vertical line, and I left the center line as a regular line, not a construction line. The only construction line here was where I drew this little arc. I'm just doing it this way to show you that there are multiple ways of doing things. So let's use the tools to get the revolve feature, which is the V key on the keyboard. Select inside the enclosed area, select the center line, and it automatically goes to 360. We can say done. From here, the next video will show you how to add more features to this part.